Pen Art Industry is up almost 2% after the company bagged an order worth 255 crores. We'll keep an eye out on that. But watch out for the financials. DHFL at the high point of the day. Other than that, you have L&T Financial Holdings, all of them moving. Yesterday's macro data perhaps rubbing off positively on these sentiments. Maybe something as far as the interest rate is concerned is on the anvil, considering the retail inflation, which came in at a record low of 2.18%. So to discuss the impact of that on the bonds, if you pull up the bond yield, you will see that the bond yields have lowered, which means the bond prices have increased. How does that impact PNB Gilts, which is the subsidiary of Punjab National Bank, holds a portfolio of investments in bonds? We have SK Dubey, the MD of the company, joining in now. Mr. Dubey, yesterday's inflation data came in lower than expected, because of which we're seeing some lower yields on the benchmark bonds. How does that impact your portfolio? What exactly is the average duration?
The average duration is 3.5.
All right.
And I think this decline in yields is almost now 16 basis points in 10-year. And the yield curve has moved even more favorably towards the upper end. There the decline is more than 20 basis points. So I think across the yield curve, there is improvement.
All right, Mr. Dubey, if you could help us out with what is the average size of your book currently? I think the last time we spoke, if I'm not mistaken, a few months ago, it was at around 3,000 crores approximately. So
3,500 is normally the average
The book size
of the portfolio.
All right.
But we have a board approval limits of 8.5 times the net owned funds.
8.5 times now?
The net owned funds, which is roughly 898 crore, is our net worth.
Okay, 890.
So we can go to much higher levels. And currently, during this period, when we want to take advantage, you naturally have a much higher level of portfolio.
All right. So I think you can go up to around what? Around 7,000 crores approximately?
7,000, yes.
And currently you are around 3,500 crores. So I just wanted to go further into that.
No, we're not. We were 3,500 in March.
Okay. And now, and in the last couple of months, have you increased the portfolio size?
Yeah, we have increased.
To around 4,000?
No, we must be in the range of a little over 5,500.
All right. 5,500 crores. All right.
Yeah.
So if you could tell us, when the bond yields were higher in the interim last quarter, did you increase your portfolio size? Did you buy at higher levels?
Yeah, we were expecting this time the RBI to be softer with the market. Not necessarily, a cut in rate, but we were expecting. And therefore, we anticipated this soft position in the market.
All right, Mr. Dubey, let's go further into your book then. If you could help us out and categorize it, how much of your book is held till maturity, and how much of it is available for sale? And also with this...
No, in primary dealers, we don't have the treasury kind of situation. We have up to the level of net owned fund.
Okay.
We can have HTM, and entire remaining portfolio is grid. We don't have that categorization.
Oh,
the primary dealers have only two. The HTM, which is equivalent to the size of net owned fund.
Correct.
And the rest is grid.
Okay, so majority of your portfolio you're saying is available for sale.
Yes.
Okay.
So in that case, does that reflect in your mark-to-market daily gains? So if the bond prices, say, have increased, can we see a concomitant impact on your financials because of that? What can we expect in the first quarter?
The pure trading that we do, every day, our portfolio is mark-to-market at the current level. So there is in trading there is no impact. Yeah, you will either you keep booking profits or you incur loss. The portfolio always remains at the level of the current market.
All right, Mr. Dubey, if you could, it seems that the stock as well is quite excited as we speak. Let's pull up the intraday chart. Looks like investors are really listening to you, Mr. Dubey. So I wanted to know what kind of a income are you looking at for this fiscal? And if you could tell us how much of the gains will come in because of the coupon rate to move, and also how much of it will come, you know, by capital gains, if you could just break that up for us.
I'll give you an idea of what we have done during the last year.
Right.
Our PBT was 256 crore, out of which 155 was trading. The rest was what you say, the coupon.
Okay, 155 was trading. Right. All right.
Yeah.
So that's roughly 60%.
That's the level, and we would like to maintain that level. You know, it's just one quarter. And going forward, we expect the rates to be... And then, you know, even if the rates go adverse, we have possibility of shorting the market. We can go both ways. So if the trading skills are good, the market is going to be good for us.
All right, trading skills are good. I don't know about that, sir, but the market is definitely good. The stock is reacting up 5% now. FY18, what is what exactly could that proportion be? You said roughly 60% of your gains in the PBT came from trading. Is that ratio likely to be the same in FY18, or is that likely to increase?
I don't know. It's just one quarter, and it's very difficult to predict what happens in the next three quarters.
Okay.
But we have sailed through all difficult times also, and we have been able to do well.
But you did
so
say
we'll try to maintain the trend.
But you did say that you expect the RBI to cut rates further, right? So lower interest rates on the annual, that means a positive FY18 for you. Is that correct assessment?
That should be. That's what we are anticipating. That is a 25 basis point cut, hopefully in August, if not later.
Fantastic. Thanks so much, Mr. Dubey, for stopping.